Hey guys, welcome back to the walkthrough. In this video, we'll be getting access to the license board, so we'll be discussing the new job system in the game. I'll also be taking on the first hunt and exploring the Delmasca Ester Sand.
Ah, Vaughn, I was waiting.
Panella said you needed something?
Had me some packages supposed to be arriving by courier. In the morning, perhaps he ran into some trouble out in the desert. Now I've no foodstuffs to prepare for the banquet tonight.
So you want me to find this courier? Hey, no problem.
No problem? The desert teams with trouble. I'd be sending you to Early Grave, my boy. No, I've arranged for some replacement goods from Tomage over at the Sand Sea.
So you want me to go to the tavern to pick him up?
Actually, I asked Kites to do that. Wouldn't you know he's gone missing on me, too? I can't leave my shop at night. Panella on another chore at the moment, you see. What I want you to do is run over to the Sand Sea and fetch Kites back. What do you say?
Sounds wild.
It's easy work, and you'll thank me for it someday.
There you are, Kites. Stop loafing around.
Look, Vaughn, look! This is it! This is why Miguelo's courier didn't get here on time.
A creature spotted in the Ester Sand. What is that thing?
Ah, Vaughn! Miguelo sent you too, did he? He's a busy man these days, that Miguelo, if I dare say so myself. I don't envy him the work, though. Not a bit. Quite the affair throwing a banquet to welcome the Imperials, eh?
Welcoming? We should be... whatever. Say, Tomage, what's this?
Nah, don't remind me. We've got some nastiness out there in the Ester Sand. What's stopping our couriers? And that means shortages all around. Thought I'd put up a bill, offer a reward to anyone who can knock that nasty back in its place.
Now that's work. Sounds 10 times better than running errands for Miguelo.
That's right! Vaughn, you should give it a shot!
And you should be getting back to Miguelo. Now, Kites. He was waiting for you.
Oh, right.
Alright, so we now have access to the license board. Now, in the new remake of Zodiac Age, we are introduced to the job system. Now, each character once has chosen a job into their license board, they cannot switch jobs. And I think many fans were very disappointed in this. I think that's why the developers decided in the remake to let you have two jobs, because I think the original Japanese version, you had one job choice. But for some reason, I don't think the fans realize this, but even though they're locked to one job, or now two, they do their job very well. Their stats are increased greatly. So the game's even easier now that there's two job options. So basically, I'm going to use every single job in the game, because there's 12 and there's 6 characters. So there's no wrong sets to choose, in my opinion. It's a matter of preference and how you like to play. For example, Vaughn's going to be my Shikari and probably my Foebreaker. Basically, he's going to be my mobile speedy tank that will take all the hits, but it'll do some damage and is kind of fast. As I said before, there's no wrong options in this. You can play certain ways to make the game even more difficult, but I'm not going to do that. And if you're wondering, I'm also not going to use that leveling up trick near the beginning of the game where you fight that stupid enemy to level up faster. That's not me. That makes the game too easy, so I'm not going to do that trick either. So start off with the Shikari job for Vaughn. And then we're going to hunt the Rogue Tomato.
You there, let's see some papers, boy. No public passage on account of the Lord Consul's parade.
Oh, gee, that's too bad. You see, it just so happens that your provisioner for the fete tonight, he sent me to pick up a few choice morsels for the, Consul's dining pleasure. He wants them quick. I got the writ of transit right here. You see? Signed, Magello. I just hate to see the Consul upset because his food wasn't ready on time. And I sure hate to see him take it out on you.
The Lord Consul is a great man, and not one to take offense at such trifling matters. Move along, boy. Wouldn't do to keep the Consul waiting. Right, gates are closed after this.
Yeah.
Galbana lilies? Never thought I'd see them growing out here. Ugh. This'll make a nice souvenir. Time to call it a day.
Back down.
I supposed to
bang? This gate's closed until the ceremony's over. Do you hear?
Now what?
Open the gate! All right, out the way.
Wait a second. How can you let these chocobos through the gate and not us?
What of it? This here's a pedigreed parader, boy.
Cost tens of thousands of gil, this one did.
A prettier price than 100 of you provincials would fetch.
Keep your distance. We don't want the chocobos sticking a peasant.
What'd you say?
Step aside! Right then, move them in.
Well, that does it.
Ho-ho-ho, a fine chocobo you have there. Yes, seat it down, Stock, if I'm not mistaken. Change the soil, change the chocobo, am I right? Yes, different soil means different bouquet, too. Take a Damascus Merlot's wine. It may lack the flavor and depth of some of your Arcadian wines, but it has a certain strength of character. It's not bad, really, once you get used to it. Care for some, sirs? There's more than enough for all to cool their throats, of course.
You let these carts through the enclosure's gate as ordered. My mail's choked with this sand.
Don't give me a scare like that. You're lucky that ended where it did.
Right. Now's our chance to go through.
Ah, the ceremony will be starting soon. I'd best be hurrying.
Okay, well... Vaughn, wait! What is it? Vaughn!
Have order. I give you your new consul, His Imperial Highness Lord Vane Solidor, Commandant of the Arcadian Empire's Western Arm. Your Excellency.
People of Rabanaster. Is it with hatred you look upon your consul? With hatred you look upon the Empire!
Spit on your Empire! Spit
back to Arcadia!
There was little point in asking. But know this. I harbor no idle hopes of frustrating that hatred. Nor shall I ask your fealty. That is the due of your fallen king, and rightly so. King Ramanas loved his people. Strove to bring you peace. His was a rule worthy of your devotion. Even now, he remains among you, protecting you. His ardor for the peace and weal of Dalmasca falters not. I would ask only that you do your king honor. Together, let us embrace the peace His Majesty would surely desire. 2 years now divide us from war's bitter end, yet still its shadow looms over all, stifling the infant peace, a pall only you may cast off. Achieve but this one thing, and your hatred of me and of the Empire will grieve me not. I will stand fast, I will endure your hatred, suffer your slings and arrows, I will defend Dalmasca. Here I will pay my debt, I swear it now. Though King Ramanas and Lady Ash be gone, they stand ever at the side of their people. In honoring peace, you do honor to their memory and to Dalmasca. What I ask plain. My hopes now rest with you.
Is Ravenaster to your liking, my lord?
It is magnificent. Take this cathedral, for instance. Elegant, yet whimsical in its execution. A stunning example of Galtean architecture. I hope Lord Gramus might one day look upon it himself.
Oh, remember the last one? They're all like this.
The patron of this evening's banquet, may it please your excellency.
Gallo, your highness. It is truly a profound honor to make the acquaintance of our future emperor, highness. The people of Ravenasta join me in welcoming
you. That's enough of highness. Though indeed I am our emperor's son, I am no prince. Arcadia's emperor is freely chosen by her people. I am but an elected official and nothing more.
I meant no disrespect.
Now that I think on it, I would not have you address me as Lord Consul, for that matter.
No?
Henceforth, I am a citizen of Ravenaster. Why don't you call me Vane?
I could not. That would not be right.
You are overly fond of formalities. I have just the remedy for that. Tonight you will join me, and we shall drink until you call me by name.
How can he stand about him like that?
Fawn, you just do not get it, do you? He's not doing it because he wants to.
Lord Vane never did.
You know what would happen if he didn't.
I know, it's just...
So, what would you do different?
I don't know. Well... I'd do something.
Fawn... Vaughn, you haven't heard a single word I've said, have you? This place has changed so much. It's like it's not even Ravenaster anymore. Like the Empire is swallowing it whole.
Hey, Pinel, that fate tonight. You think they'll let us in?
Are you crazy? It's in the palace, and we don't have an invitation if you hadn't noticed.
So, how are we getting in?
As if I'd know. Why not ask Magello to get you in? Or go see old Dallin in Lowtown? Why the sudden interest, Vaughn?
I told you. I'm going to take back what's ours. Give back to Dalmasca. Come on. What do you think? If I find something, and it fetches a good price, how about I buy you all dinner?
Oh, please. You know as well as I do the first thing you'd buy is an airship. All hail Vaughn, Sky Pirate of Dalmasca. It's got a nice ring to it. Stay out of trouble.
An airship. I don't know. Maybe. But not through Magello. Time to pay old Dallin a visit.
Alright, video is long enough now, so thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe for more.